that these two will not be able to get the 3 points today. Who's it going to be? As you can see, the atmosphere is absolutely tremendous. Many of those sides, Graham, hoping for a draw tonight. Leo Messi, we can see there, a little bit of a smile on his face. The big news this week, of course, that Leo Medround, the lineup selected by Marcelino to face the challenge tonight. Neto in goal. At the back, former Barca man Martin Montoya, Ezequiel Garay, Gabriel Paulista and Jose Gaya. And in midfield, Condogbia and Parejo, this excellent pairing of central midfielders with Gonzalo Guedes on the left and Carlos Soler on the right. And up front, the two informed strikers, Simone Zaza and Rodrigo Moreto. Football Club Barcelona tonight, Marc Ter Stegen in goal. At the back, Nelson Semedo, Thomas Vermaelen, will be talking about him over the evening for sure. Samuel Umtiti and Jordi Alba. In midfield, Ivan Rakitic, Paulinho, Busquets and Iniesta. And up front, Luis Suarez and Leo Messi. And you can hear the silence taking over at Mr.
Levy. Started in May and brought us to this point this quickly has been astonishing.
Barcelona gets things underway with Samuel Umtiti picking out Paulinho. Jordi Alba, his first touch inside the tee. Messi lays it off again to his fullback. Now back to Paulinho. He's going to try a shot. Well, a first attempt for Barcelona. Paulinho having a go. And it's tipped over the bar by Neto. It'll be a corner for Barca with 3.5 minutes on the clock.
It was an absolute key moment just a second ago when Zaza won that ball from Paulinho. And everybody watching is thinking,
top. Headed away by Garay. Soler with the touch. He gives it away to Iniesta. Here's Rakitic. Rakitic with the shot. No problems for Neto. Two shots from Barca in the first 10 minutes from well outside the Valencia area.
They played with a verve and a precision and a confidence which you might expect having played so well in Turin.
On a Sunday afternoon, Dani Parejo inside the box. They've lost it again though. It's Suarez. Messi! Oh, and it's in the back of the net. That one crossed the line. Neto!
And it's too late. I'm guessing, but my guess is that you're right that this is a goal.
I think it's... I mean, that
and
is
and now there's no
nearly half a metre over the
now
line.
There's no question.
It's astonishing how quickly Messi hits that with the inside of his right foot, I believe.
It was beautiful.
On the half volley, completely takes Neto by surprise. I don't think the Brazilian keeper... And well held this time by Neto. Had to get down low. But Messi won't be pleased. Well, I think we've seen his reactions. Obviously, he's not pleased. And that's concerning when Leo Messi's on the rival side. Having an annoyed Messi play. Iniesta. Messi. Iniesta. Messi. Iniesta with the shot. Beautiful football from Football Club Barcelona. Mesmeric stuff. And there was absolutely nothing this Valencia side could do to prevent what Barca were building up there.
From my understanding of football, my taste for football, Simon, this is by a significant distance the best that Barcelona have played under Valverde. The only equivalent is the 3-0 Champions League win in the first group game where they hadn't scored until the 45th minute and hadn't played.
It gives you confidence having a player like Ter Stegen as your last line of defence, I suppose. Here's Messi over the top for Suarez. Suarez has to bully his way through, and he does it, and it's blocked in the end. It falls for Messi. Messi, and it's blocked again. And finally, Contona. There's Gaia battling with Suarez.
There are referees who are going to give a foul either outside the box for the first offence or the second. Well done, Neto, for redeeming yourself. But in the breakaway move that comes because Leo Messi doesn't want to finish off his right foot, we saw
Parejo. This is better from Valencia. Rodrigo, he's got Guedes in space. Guedes into the area, cuts it back. Zaza with the shot. It went through Vermaelen's legs, but was always curling away from the post. That's a decent restart from the home side.
The rhythm is better, they're playing higher up the pitch. He thinks about a first-time shot here. Look at him, he's almost about to draw the trigger. The only thing is that he can't, for the lack of bodies, he can't angle it correctly inside that post.
Go. Danger here. Here's Guedes. Guedes, Rodrigo and Zaza. Still Guedes gets away from him. Titi. And Ter Stegen just does enough and then shows great bravery to collect the loose ball.
Fantastic. Our angle here in the commentary is perfect to know that Guedes always knew that because he was facing Umtiti rather than Semedo, Umtiti's right foot is not as strong, and he went outside. But from that angle, you can't see that.
I think Zaza was very intelligent there in winning that free kick. But to my mind, there wasn't much in it. Guedes on the overlap. Gaia. Gaia cuts it back. And Valencia get ahead. It's Rodrigo. 1-0 to Valencia. Watch out for this side. After a very poor first half, they've come back highly motivated, and it's taken them less than 15 minutes to break the deadlock. Nothing Ter Stegen could do there. Rodrigo whipping in to the near post and bundling the ball over the line, and Mestalla erupts, and what a celebration. There's Rodrigo.
That is for the president. Jaume Orti is the reason for the mad red wig. But I said in the first half, Simon, and I want to go back to it, I fancy Guedes against Semedo.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe that he wasn't being put one-on-one with the Portuguese more often. The overlap is perfect. The cross is good. Rodrigo's arrival is perfect. But this moment, the take, yeah, hold and give, where there's nobody running with Gaia. And at that point, unless Gaia's distribution is... And that's what a great shot to see the look, to check. It's not a hit and hope, as you see so many wide men failing to avoid. The ball is perfect, but that opening comes from Guedes.
It's just too far away from Ter Stegen to make him go down, and if he doesn't get enough of a glove on it, it comes through to Rodrigo. Nothing Vermaelen or Umtiti could have done. Barcelona will be feeling a little bit hard done by at this stage. Here's Messi, now Suarez. Straight at the keeper. Whether the flag had gone up, I think it had. And you can see once again, it's just this time here.
But it's, that's it, it's small details. So once again,
it's picked up straight away by Kondogbia. Well, I'm not quite sure what he's trying to do. He's trying to pick out Guedes, and he does. Guedes turning away from Semedo. And off balance, he couldn't make the shot. I think De La Feo might have been just did enough. But that's the position we've seen Guedes score before this season. Real danger for Bob.
The Frenchman was enormously quick to intercept. And here's the moment where Suarez gets a lucky break because of the bounce of the ball. But for the first time tonight, reminds us of why he was the world's number one centre forward for so long. Good save by the Brazilian, who's beginning to redeem him.
Suarez, busy presence and coming off the bench. Leo Messi looking for Jordi Alba. What a classic goal for Barcelona. The former Valencia man returns to Mestalla. There's none of this nonsense about not celebrating that one. What an assist from Leo Messi. What an amazing goal from Football Club Barcelona. Jordi Alba is absolutely unmoved by the response of Mestalla. Barcelona are back into it. Valencia 1, Barca 1, and still with stoppage time, 10 minutes or more to go.
It's time for the thing from Love Story, aka Where Do I Begin? The world's greatest player releases a pass that shouldn't be possible, and it's as good as Hristo Stoichkov's, sorry, Jordi Alba's finish was. And I did warn you earlier on that he considered himself an inside forward as he began his career. Scored for Spain in each of the two international matches against Russia and Costa Rica. As you say,
both of these two will not be able to...